Hello and welcome to Nameables. If you look up at the sky on a clear night, you'll be able to distinguish moon craters, which are often named after great deceased scientists. One of these craters is named al-Wafa. Al-Wafa al-Bisjani was born in 940 CE in present-day Iran and was one of the leading astronomers and mathematicians of the world. He traveled to Baghdad at a young age. Back then, Baghdad was the capital of an Islamic dynasty that strongly supported and funded scientific projects such as Baghdad Observatory, in which al-Wafa used to work. There, he managed to calculate the estimate of the longitude between two different cities through simultaneous observation of the lunar eclipse in those two cities.
Mission completed.
Bisjani's project also helped ordinary people in their everyday life. He organized the calculations of clerks and businessmen and corrected their methods, such as the calculation of area for shapes with four angles. In the eastern provinces of the Islamic dynasty, where it wasn't common to use numbers, al-Wazjani's works explained sometimes very complicated mathematical concepts using words alone. Al-Wazjani is also famous for his astronomical calculations, which depend greatly on the precision of sign tables. In his astronomical work, al-Wafa used all trigonometric functions and calculated tables for them. He was also the first one to ever take all previously known trigonometric knowledge and condense it into one chronological piece of work. The amazing thing is that this work of his, that's over 1,000 years old, bears a strong resemblance to modern trigonometry in some places. But al-Wafa didn't stop there. He also added a ton of new developments to the field. He constructed new and more precise sine tables and simplified the solutions to spherical trigonometry. He defined the terms tangent, cotangent, sine, cosine, secant, and cosecant, and all the basic relations between them. This is why it is safe to say that he was the first person to discover the most accurate and comprehensive trigonometric formulas that we still use today. Out of the 22 different books that al-Bisjani wrote, only 7 have survived. An imperfect copy of his book al-Majist, meaning trigonometry, is currently kept in Paris. Even with this limited access to his books, his knowledge has influenced the entire world in trigonometry. Al-Bisjani's trigonometric knowledge was so advanced for his time that no scholar was able to add to it for some 7 centuries after. That's until de Moivre published his famous theorem, followed by Euler and Lambert, who introduced the hyperbolic trigonometric function. Al-Wafa was also one of the scholars who introduced geometric dissection puzzles. To solve these puzzles, one has to create a specific geometric shape using other shapes, and to this day, mathematicians are finding new solutions for them. Henry E. Dudeney, the greatest English creator of mathematical puzzles in the 20th century, was one of those who succeeded in solving a puzzle of Bisjani. Now, it seems like al-Wafa created these puzzles for the entertainment of great minds, but they were later used in intricate architecture as well. Today, we live in a world where everyone carries a mini computer in the shape of a smartphone in their pockets. We have to remind ourselves that the luxuries that we are accustomed to today would be impossible without great mathematical discoveries like those of al-Bisjani, the man the likes of whom only come about every once in a blue moon.